Joining us now, Tamil Nadu Health Secretary, Dr. J. Radhakrishnan. Doctor, thank you very much for your time. Tamil Nadu has given 97 lakh doses so far. How many have taken both doses, sir?
So only around 22.06 lakh people have taken both the doses. And this has been an issue which both Government of India officials and we keep telling people that, you know, it is not just important to get vaccinated once, but you have to get vaccinated in a complete fashion so that you get proper immunity. Of course, having said that, for Covishield, the timing has been changed a bit. So accordingly also there will be some delay. But overall, we are monitoring, you know, how many people, and we are also alerting them, those who are supposed to have taken the dose and they have not taken, we are alerting them.
Even among the total number of doses, Tamil Nadu stands among the lowest. Any particular reason for this?
See, one, of course, you know, it has to be, we have to calculate our performance based on allocation. But having said that, you know, I need to tell that in the initial stages, when we started the vaccination in January 16, our performance used to be ranged from 3,000 to 20,000 because Tamil Nadu used to have a massive amount of vaccine hesitancy. You would remember that, you know, we had to lead and important opinion leaders had to take. In spite of that, the offtake used to be less. So that is why during that time, Kerala and all, which did much better in vaccine uptake, and that time cases were also high in Kerala. So that also probably creates an awareness. And they did, so Kerala compared to the population got much higher. Similarly, Gujarat, they have got much higher, Maharashtra, other states where they did much better. Now, we personally feel that, you know, it should not be held against Tamil Nadu. Now, there is no vaccine hesitancy. So when there is no vaccination, and people are taking it in a big way. So we need to calculate it based on the running last 3 days or 4 days and supply. Government of India has more than doubled the allocation from May to June. But in spite of that, I am sure that, you know, we will be capable of doing much more vaccination. Similarly, Tamil Nadu also in the initial stages had a challenge of wastage because of hesitancy. You cannot return back the coming person also. So that also did impact. But now both we have tackled and we are doing quite well. Once the vaccine is available, on a day we are capable of doing almost 3.5 lakh. We plan to increase it up to 6 lakhs if we do get such an amount of supply, which I'm sure during the coming months it will happen based on what Government of India says, that new companies are likely to come and existing companies are going to increase the production.
Although the mortality rate is quite low, sir, 1.1-1.2%, some studies show there's a huge gap compared to the numbers declared in terms of deaths due to COVID and the historical deaths data. In Chennai, for instance, they say it could be 8 times more than what is being declared.
See, basically, I don't go into too much of this kind of speculations and statistics. We need to understand there is a birth rate. Every day, almost 2,800 people get born. And every day, around roughly 2,000 people die in Tamil Nadu due to various, it could be cardiac arrest, it could be cancer. COVID, there is an ICMR guideline for declaration of death. Who is RT-PCR positive? And he is declared. Plus, even if he is exacerbated due to COVID, it may be due to other causes, but exacerbated, and RT-PCR they declare. Similarly, those who are clinically RT-PCR negative, but clinically and suspected COVID, we do. But beyond that, you know, one of the states which gives maximum number of death declaration, and in every day, we give in detail. And even delayed declaration. Somebody is not able to produce ICMR, but after 15 days, he comes back and says, this is my ICMR, the hospital comes. We include it. So there is, and similarly, we have a reconciliation committee which looks at such differences and does. So people need not speculate and think that, you know. And again, the present government stand is that unless you declare the death in a transparent manner, then only the fear also, awareness and fear comes together. Suppose if we artificially give a less picture, people will say this disease does not cause death. So absolute number wise also, we like to be very clear. We are one of the highest. We went up to 490 odd deaths and now it is around 400. That itself is another question. People say, why 400 people are dying? So we have two opposite questions coming in. We don't go by either way, don't get immunity. We just go by ICMR guideline. Tell people not to tamper with the ICMR way of declaration. Then there is a form 4 and all. At a grassroots level, if something incorrectly happens, we get it rectified through reconciliation.
But nothing yet to be declared in terms of numbers? No backlog?
Nothing yet to be declared. And there we have a permanent reconciliation committee which sits on a weekly basis. Right. Even in a deferred time, we come to know X has died due to COVID, according to ICMR guideline, but got failed to declare, get declared. He or she gets included in the subsequent thing.
Lastly, even after 1 month long of steady decline, almost for 18 consecutive days, that in terms of tally, daily tally, Tamil Nadu stands on the top with 17,000. Any specific challenges this time?
See, one, we have to understand that Tamil Nadu peaked later. Second is we do 1.8 lakh RT-PCR tests, and we want to ensure that we keep on mopping up the contacts and also the containment areas, and also do fever camp. Third is we shouldn't compare. There were days when other states were higher. So that time also we never used to show that, you know, other states are higher, we are lower. So this is a pandemic, and this is the way the disease is running through the course. We need people to change their behavior. We need to understand that it is not like a competitive way how another state or neighboring state does, but how we ensure that we are smarter than corona in following the corona preventive behavioral changes. Quite a lot of awareness is there. Tamil Nadu's challenge is it awareness has to change into change in behavior of not only wearing mask properly and all, but more importantly, Tamil Nadu's challenge is even now, while quite a 38,000 odd people get discharged, even now we have cases when people come at a breathlessness stage to the hospital for the first time. So that is why in a micro plan, we are going house to house on a regular basis to identify them and encourage them to come. So these are challenging times. We are proud of the grassroots work where they have reduced it to 50%. But we keep telling them that even this 50% reduction, like you say, it is Tamil Nadu still stand, is number one. But more than being number one at present, we have, compared to the lowest, we are X times higher. So we are working as a team to ensure that deaths come down. And also this peak comes down. And parallelly, we also want to keep focus on augmenting both the oxygen supplies, looking at the additional, considering, you know, situation in Japan and all, we have to be guarded and not be lackadaisical.
Unlike Chennai, not all districts have screening centers. Is that screening centers?
No, I would like to correct that impression. All centers, see what happens, Chennai gets covered. I have gone to 23 districts with Honorable Minister, and I visited almost 200 villages and towns recently. We are now going to plan. There are places where block level triaging centers are there, intermediate COVID care centers are there, but they don't get their due, you know, they don't get to, public doesn't get to know. You told collectors. So wherever you have a success story, wherever you have challenges, share with the media. So then only the media will come to know what efforts you are taking. Otherwise, you know, just like Chennai reduction, the statewide 37,000 number will not reduce to 70,000 if the district level teams have not done so much of work.
Thank you so much, Dr. for your time. That was Dr. J. Radhakrishnan talking to us in Chennai with Shah Vijay, Sam Daniel, Find It TV.